Chair,
distinguished scholars, policymakers, and friends. As Dinesh rightly said, this meeting is with a view to launch the Indian chapter of GlobalX. And GlobalX is a network of scholars who use learning, innovation, and competence building as their framework to understand the issues relating to innovation and development. And the GlobalX has chapters in Asia called Asianix, in Africa called Africanix, in China called Sicalix, and a chapter in Latin America is Lalix. It is also in a very vibrant form. And India was, we are the last, not the last, in fact others are also joining. And in last Kuala Lumpur conference, we were something like 22 from India, and we formed a group and we decided that we shall form a India chapter. And I congratulate Dinesh, Raji, and with the leadership of Parthasarathy Banerjee to launch this event. To my mind, the theme selected for this, we could not have selected a better theme than what is selected by Dinesh and his colleagues for launching this conference. And I also would like to inform you that today we are also launching a new journal called Innovation and Development. It is, in essence, a journal from CDS and NISTARS. CDS is Center for Development Studies, Trivandrum, is an institute started in 1971 focusing on development studies. And as you're aware, NISTARS is another institute which, in this country for the first time, focused on issues relating to science, technology, and development. And we are very happy that we could join with them in this event. But I also apologize, and I feel bad that I could not contribute to the extent that we should have for many reasons, including distance. Now, I also, today this journal from, this journal is also from GlobalX. We have got leading development scholars from India, development economics scholars from India, GlobalX leaders, innovation scholars from GlobalX, and a large number of innovation scholars from India. I mean, that editorial board consists of something like over 130 scholars from 38 countries. And I take this opportunity to invite all of you very cordially for the evening launching of this journal in India International Center. I'm sorry that if any I failed to reach you through my personal invitation. I mean, I wanted to send personal invitation to all of you. I was told that some of them got 5-6 invitations, and some of them have not got here in the morning. I'm extremely sorry for this academic or unorganized way of doing it. And please kindly take this as a personal invitation and join us in the evening in India International Center at 7 o'clock for the launch of this journal. Now, coming to the theme of what we are going to discuss, I'll be very brief. In 1998, one of the influential report on the growth report by a group of leading scholars, including a few Nobel Prize winners, they have sent a message to developing countries. When I read that report, I reminded of what was said in the Bible, saying that lucky are those who are poor because the heaven is for them. The message from this particular report is saying that the road to prosperity is not as rocky it used to be under the age of globalization. They said that the limits to market, which was long back said by Adam Smith said that your division of labor, which is a key factor for improving efficiency, is constrained by or limited by the extent of market. According to this report, because of globalization, market is no more limited. At the same time, they added that the today's globalized environment provides an opportunity for the first import or transfer of ideas and technologies and know-how from the rest of the world. And the approach that they have suggested is essentially a market-driven approach towards achieving this transfer and development of technology. And we know that the idea of drawing from others and learning from others is something what Frederick List wrote as early as in 1841. He wrote saying that Any country is rich only to the extent to which it could draw from the knowledge set from of the previous generation. But today, when we are sitting here, after playing with the globalization, we know that the market-driven approach towards learning from others has got obvious limits. And the strategy of Global Innovation Network, which is often highlighted as the strategy towards shortcut to innovation, growth, and prosperity, Dieter says it is actually what is called a poison chalice. In fact, recently I have done a project with the EU, or we have done it through Global X Network. In fact, my conclusion is that Global Innovation Network rather could be Global Innovation Traps. So what I'm trying to say is that when we are approaching the problem of innovation and development, there are obvious limits to the often advocated strategies. And when we talk about innovation, we have to take the concept of innovation much beyond what was advocated in the early 1970s Sussex Manifesto. And today we are talking in a world where innovation is not just a matter of linear invention, innovation, diffusion, but it is an interactive process, as Global X scholars, along with others, would argue. It is an interactive process, it is a cumulative process, it is an incremental process, it is a socially embedded process. So the whole purpose of IndiaX and the whole purpose of the group here is, I think, including the experience that our key speaker will be providing to us, is to learn from what is, we have to see the innovation system and innovation from a developing country perspective, and how much we can progress in that, and your success in harnessing innovation for development depends upon how you can learn from your own. So with this, and I hope this group, we will be able to, I mean, we have been, I think all of you are here, been for a long time working on this, and I hope the formation of IndiaX and formation of this group will help us in taking this agenda to further heights. Thank you very much.